Today we have to start an other lecture about the road failure regarding the cracking known as the Brock cracking. First of all, let me tell you first this, what is the Brock cracking? As this word shows, Brock cracking mean those types of the cracks which are bigger in size, like this one which I have drawn over here, maybe like this one or maybe more than that, etc. So this type of the cracking which you will see on the road, so this pattern of this cracking is known as the Brock cracking. Normally, for your understanding, let me tell you about its sizes. Minimum size of this one can be 1 foot by 1 foot. This is the minimum size. It can be more. So keep this thing in mind. Okay, it can have the size of 1 foot by 1 foot. This is the minimum size, or it can be more. So what is the fundamental definition? You see, these cracks are interconnected with each other. When this interconnected pattern in rectangular shape shown over here is known as Brock cracking. Very easy to understand this definition. Interconnected pattern in the rectangular shape is known as our Brock cracking, and its dimension already I have given you, 1 foot by 1 foot, or it can be more. Whenever you will see such type of this cracking on the road, from here you should keep in mind this. So the asphalt has aged. This is also a very important point. When asphalt has aged, it means that we can say that they are occurring on old asphalt pavement. Because very easy way I am going to explain it to you for your clear understanding. Like, first of all, asphalt age means now I have to make its link with this Brock cracking. It means they are occurring on the old asphalt pavement, and that's it. From this definition or from this figure, now we will proceed further for our description. Like, it is also said that these types of the cracks are also produced whenever you say that horizontal shrinkage of the asphalt is happening. You know, horizontal shrinkage. When horizontal shrinkage of the asphalt is happening and very little stress is being applied vertically, then this type of the cracking will be produced on the surface. So from this one, let me tell you what are the causes. So we will just try to understand causes of Brock cracking. First of all, asphalt surface shrinkage. You know, when we talk about this asphalt surface shrinkage, why this is shrinking? From this, we can write down another point for our understanding. Average, or you can say that daily temperature variation or cycling. Very easy to learn this one. Third point, your bitumen mix made with material of aggregate. Your aggregate may have absorbed tip characteristics. When your aggregate may have this absorption characteristics, then we can say that block cracking will occur. Next, poor drainage system. Very important point. Now I am going to tell you. After this poor drainage system, you know, what is the foundation of our road structure? Your subgrade material. So we can say that I am not going to write SG means subgrade. Your subgrade material possess shrinkage property. Keep this in mind. Your subgrade material possess the shrinkage property. Due to this shrinkage property, we can say that crack is initiated. And then it is shown on the surface. And then shown on surface. Clear it? Now, another very easy point, let me tell you also, because that's also very important for you to understand. Point number 6. I have talked about the aggregate. If in this mix, mix mean hard mix expert, my bitumen is of low penetration grade. And stiffness is high. Use is less. Then crack will be initiated. Crack mean BC mean block cracking. Crack will be initiated. So up to now I have given you the this definition. Then what are the major causes for the occurrence of this block cracking, which I have explained you over here for your understanding, and I hope you may have understood it very well. If you have any question related to this type of the cracking, you can ask me. Now after these causes, I will now go to this one, remedial action. Remedial action means you have seen this crack on the surface. Now, if surface is left untreated or if we have not considered it, then road is completely damaged. Road will no more be able to save further traveling. Now, I will explain you the remedial action. Very easy point. Use sealant material in cracking. This is common. In all, you can use it. Provided, where will you use? If your crack is not of severe nature. Second, my point is, Your crack is of severe nature. This road, we can say that, is no more able to travel. There, replace the old asphalt. Layer with new asphalt, HMA layer. Third one, I have given 2 points in the causes. Develop proper drainage system. Mandatory, because if you have good drainage system, your road is going to sustain its life. Fourth one, I have told you, subgrade shrinkage. How I will tackle this? My last point, subgrade shrinkage. You know, I have done the analysis where I see that much of my road is having the block cracking, it's no more safe. I will cut certain area, I will go to this subgrade material, and then I will check what are the characteristics. How is my subgrade material? Then I reach to this conclusion, this my subgrade material has more amount of clay content, which is not compatible to be used as your road formation level. So there, when this subgrade material has this shrinkage characteristics, it is being replaced. Keep this. It is being replaced means I have to start the construction of a road right from the lowest level up to the top. Okay, I will make the layer of the subgrade material, then I will put the sub-based material, then after that I will go to my asphaltic layer. So that is why, if your subgrade material has the shrinkage characteristics, it means we have to replace it. That's why it is being replaced with new material, new good subgrade material, and make the new road. That's why, if you will go through any project specification, it is always mentioned what should be the characteristics of the subgrade material. If sometime this test is not done, okay, in order to check the liquid limit and plastic limit, because that's very mandatory test. If that test is not done and it's just laid road, it would be good. Then such type of the problem will come in future. There you will have to go to this action, because this material is no more good. You will have to replace with some good subgrade material. Then you will start making the new road. And thank you very much for seeing this one. And if you have any query, you can ask me. Thank you for your time.